Dear students, today we will have a lecture on sex determination, that is a topic of genetics in which how sex is determined, how an individual have a male or female sex, that we will understand by this lecture. Sex determination is the process of sex differentiation by which whether a particular individual will develop into male or female sex. Sex expression is governed by chromosomes and genes. In unisexual animals, chromosomes are of two types, autosomes and allosomes. What are autosomes? Chromosomes which do not differ in morphology and number in male and female are called as autosomes. Also, these chromosomes control the vegetative characters of an organism. The another type of chromosomes, they are called as allosomes or the sex chromosomes. Chromosomes which differ in morphology and number in male and female containing genes that determine the sex. So the sex chromosome will decide whether the individual will be male or it is female. The unisexual diploid individual have two sex chromosomes and rest are autosomes. In most plant, male and female reproductive organs are found in the same flower, is called as bisexual or hermaphrodite. In nematodes, earthworm, both male and female reproductive organs are found in same individual. Male and female reproductive organs are found in the different flowers of same plant, is called as monoecious. Example, mage, castor, coconut, etc. In some plants, male and female flowers are produced on different plants, is called as dioecious. Example is papaya. So here the how sex are distributed on various organisms or on the same organism, depending on that we can call them unisexual, bisexual, monoecious, dioecious. Difference between autosomes and allosomes. Then how these chromosomes are different from each other. There are two types of chromosomes are found in human beings, as in insects or some in other organisms. The autosomes refer to other than sex chromosomes. They do not determine the sex of individual, or you can say they control the vegetative characters of an organism. The allosomes are the sex chromosomes that determine the sex of individuals. Autosomes, the chromosome number is 2n-1, and here the number of chromosome is 2 as allosomes. The chromosomes or morphology is similar in male and female. They are different in male and female, as they may be X or Y. So they are always XX in female and XY in male. The autosomes differs from species to species, whereas in each diploid organisms only 2 allosomes are found. The autosomes do not exhibit sex linkage, whereas allosomes exhibit sex linkage also. How sex is determined? There are three important mechanisms by which sex can be determined in an organisms. First is chromosomal sex determination, another is monogenic sex determination, and third is environmental sex determination. First we'll take chromosomal sex determination. In a diploid individual, there are 2n-2 autosomes and 2 sex chromosomes. These type of chromosomal sex determination are the sex determination by allosomes, second, the diploid haploid system of sex determination, and third is genic balance system. The allosomal sex determination, here the examples are given. Allosomes or sex chromosomes are generally of X and Y type, but in some birds they are Z and W types. Sex with similar type of sex chromosome, XX, is known as homogametic sex, and with this similar type of sex chromosome XY as heterogametic sex. There are four different systems of allosomal sex determination. First, XX, XY female male system. Second, XX, XO female male system. Third, XO, XX female male system. And ZW, ZZ female male system. So there are four type of autosomal sex determination process in which how sex is determined by these sex chromosomes will see in further slides. The XX, XY female male system that is found in Drosophila, man and some other mammals. In this system, female has two sex chromosomes, is homogametic and produces only one type of gamete, that is X. The male has one X and another Y chromosome, is heterogametic and produces two types of gametes with X and Y. The union of X ovum with X sperm leads to the development of female sex, that is XX. If X ovum unites with Y sperm, it produces male sex, that is XY. So how the X and Y chromosome decides the maleness and femaleness of an organism. The second system, that is XX, XO, female male system. It is found in grasshoppers and many Orthoptera and Hemiptera insects. In this system, female has double X chromosomes and male has single X chromosome. The female is homogametic and produces all the eggs with X chromosomes. The male is heterogametic, which produces sperms, half of which have X chromosome and the other have none chromosome. Union of egg with sperm having X chromosome will give rise to female sex, and with sperm having none result in the development of male sex. So here presence of XX chromosome results into the female, and XO will result into male. Now third system, that is XO XX system. In very few species of insect like Fumia, this type of system is found. In this system, female has only one X chromosome and hence is heterogametic. As a result of meiosis, 50% egg of such female carry an X chromosome and remaining 50% have none of the chromosome. On the other hand, male has two sex chromosome, that is X chromosome, and produces all the sperms with one type of gametes which are having only X chromosome. Thus, male is homogametic. The union of X sperm with ovum having X chromosome gives rise to the male sex, and union of X sperm with ovum having none sex chromosome leads to the development of female. So it is the just reverse system, unlike the birds in which XX XO system is found, here XO XX system is found. Fourth system, that is ZW ZZ female male system, that is found in birds, butterflies and moths. The female is heterogametic and produces two types of gamete, that is Z and W type. Male is homogametic and produces all the sperms of same type carrying one Z chromosome. Union of Z sperm with ovum having Z chromosome gives rise to the male, and union of Z sperm with ovum having W chromosome leads to the development of female sex. So by this, all these four methods, how we can decide the sex chromosome, or the allosomes can decide the system of sex in the organisms. The second system, that is diploid haploid system, which is found in honeybee, ants and termites. The honeybee, the female have diploid chromosome number, that is 2N is equal to 32. And the drones or males having haploid N is equal to 16 chromosomes. The females are the queen and workers, whereas the female which feed on the royal jelly develop into queen, and the queen is fertile and workers are sterile females. The queen produces haploid eggs. However, haploid male bees produces haploid sperm by mitosis rather than by meiosis. Union of egg which sperm gives rise to the diploid larva, which become the female. So in honeybee, we can see the system where you can see the two types of male and female. They are having different type of chromosomes, which is an unique example. You can see the female is with 32 chromosomes, whereas the male is having only 16 chromosomes. So males are meant for only copulation and the generation of the new generation for the future, which combines with the eggs of females that is having 16 chromosomes, and the male is also having 16 chromosomes, which is in the form of sperm, where there is no meiosis, and with the mitotic division, it produces only 16 chromosome containing sperms. You can see here the queen eggs are produced, that is N, and the diploid larvae, no royal jelly, workers will be formed, and here haploid larvae, which develops into drones, whereas drone is having single N chromosomes, it fertilizes with the egg, and zygote is formed, which develops into, if they are having royal jelly with them, then queen female will be developed, and with no royal jelly, then worker or sterile female will be developed. The genetic balance system, that is the system developed by Bridges in 1922 in Drosophila. According to the theory, the sex of an individual is determined by balance between the genes or for maleness and those for femaleness present in the individual. The genetic balance theory states that the sex determining genes are present on both X chromosome as well as in autosomes. The male sex determined gene are present on autosomes, and female sex determined genes are found on X chromosomes. The sex expression is determined by the balance of genes on autosomes and X chromosomes. In other words, the expression of sex depends on the ratio of X chromosomes to that of the autosomes. This ratio is represented as X divided by A ratio. So, genetic balance system is another system where how this type of genetic determination is defined in the generations. The genetic balance is governed by X divided by A index. Individual with index of 1 develop into female, and those with sex index of 0.5 into male. In the sex index in between 1 and 0.5, resulting individual will be neither a female nor a male, but have an intermediate sex expression and is called as intersex. The sex index of 1.5, which is higher than the sex index of normal female, giving rise to the super female. And the sex index of 0.33, which is lower than sex index of normal male, gives rise to the super male. So how male, female, intersex, super male, super female are developed by the X divided by A index. Here the example is given in the table. Ploidy is 2N, the number of chromosome is 3, that is X chromosome, and the number of autosomes are 2, so 3 by 2 is equal to 1.5, and when XA index is 1.5, then it is super female. Similar example is given in the next, where 4 by 3, 1.33, that is more than 1, and it is super female. If it is 1, 4 beta 4, then it is female. If it is 3 by 3, also female. It is 2 by 2, it is female. And if it is 3 by 4, then it is 0.75. It is lesser than 1.0, it becomes intersex. It is between 0.5 to 1.0. Similarly, in 2 by 3, that is also 0.67, which is also between 0.5 to 1, and it is also intersex. Whereas it is 1 by 2, 0.5 it is male. If 2 by 4, then it is also male. And if it is 1 by 3, that is less than 0.5, then it is super male. So how X divided by A index defines the sex in the organisms? Number of autosomal sets. Individuals with the sex index of 1.5 0 are normal females, XX diploid female, XX triploid female, and XXX X, that is tetraploid fly. The flies having the sex index of 0.5 are normal males, that is XO diploid flies, and XXOO tetraploid fly. That is monogenic sex determination. The expression of sex is influenced by a single gene is called as monogenic sex determination. In Drosophila, a transformer gene, TRA, which is present on the autosomes, plays an important role in sex expression. Transformer gene is recessive and hence does not have any effect on heterozygous condition, that is tra on the either sex. In homozygous condition, that is small tra, this gene transforms the normal diploid female into sterile males. Similarly, SRY gene is found in human. The gene is probably present on autosomes and transforms the normal male into female. Such males have a feminine or female characters. They have internal degenerated testes and are sterile. This condition is known as testicular feminization. Similar effect of single recessive gene on expression of sex have been found in some other animals, such as goats, pigs, dogs, etc., is also seen. Third is environmental sex determination. The sex determination in some organisms, such as sea worm, that is Bonelli and Dinophilus, and the horsetail plant, is governed by environmental condition and also includes some hormonal effects. In Bonelia, the larva which remain free in the sea water and settle on the sea bottom are differentiated into female, while those larvae which settle on the proboscis of female develop into tiny males. So undifferentiated larvae, if it is free living larva, develop into female. Larva attached to the proboscis of female, then develop into male. In turtle, alligators and crocodiles, the incubation temperature of egg high, 30 to 35 degrees centigrade, then it will develop into female. And if this incubation temperature is low, 23 to 28 degrees centigrade, then it develops into male. Sex mosaic in Drosophila. The sex mosaic is a combination of male and female features in the body of individual. Or you can see the both sex are found in the same organism. Example is Drosophila, looks like a mosaic. The Drosophila flies, 1 in 2000 have male tissues in one part of the body and female tissues on other part of the body. Individuals with such sex mosaic are known as gynandromorphs, gynanders. Three patterns of sex mosaic may be found in Drosophila. First is bilateral sex mosaic. One side of the fly is male and the other side of the female. This is most common type of sex mosaic. The another, anterior posterior sex mosaic, the front half of the fly is one sex and the rear half of this fly is other sex. Third, sex mosaic in patches. Sometimes only quarter of the body is male and rest of female, or just a small patch of tissue may be male and rest of the body is female. So such sex mosaic is found in Drosophila in various types. So it is all about the sex determination. Thank you very much. Okay.